thanks also goes to B&M Mercantile of Waynesfield for providing the complimentary 44 sports t-shirts. See B&M Mercantile for all of your screen printing and embroidery wearables. Call B&M Mercantile at 568-2152. We also give thanks to East of Chicago Pizza and Wapakoneta for providing the food for our crew during tonight's broadcast. For great pizza, call East of Chicago at 739-7666. Also, for the area's finest quality meats since 1930, it's Winners Quality Meats. It's always Winners Quality Meats in Osgood. Tonight's game also brought to you by Dynamic Weld in Osgood, where they know welding. For all of your welding jobs, big or small, rely on the company who strives to be the best, Dynamic Weld in Osgood. And tonight's game is also brought to you by Luger's Insurance Agency. For the very best in insurance services, see the fine folks at Luger's Insurance Agency in Mariastein. Service comes first with Luger's. Tonight's game also brought to you by Hulsman Automotive. When you need the best in automotive service and parts, see Hulsman Automotive in Chickasaw. And Community Lanes is proud of both teams in tonight's game. Open bowling each weekend is fun for the whole family at Community Lanes in Minster. Get set, folks. It should be a good one as Minster takes on Marion Local for the district title. Up next on 44 Sports.
I'm Randy Custer, General Manager at Raby Ford Lincoln Mercury. We're proud to have just been awarded the Blue Oval Certification Award from Ford Motor Company, an award only shared and honored by Ford dealers for high marks in customer satisfaction in sales and service. See for yourself why Raby Ford Lincoln Mercury is Blue Oval certified. The next time you need a new or used vehicle, service or bodywork, Raby Ford Lincoln Mercury in Delphus.
Hi, I'm Pete Williams with the Old Barn Out Back, inviting you to come out and join us and experience country cooking at its best. Our salad bar is loaded with all sorts of fresh fruits and vegetables. We bake our own desserts, breads, and rolls, including our famous cinnamon rolls. Try our buffets with the best fried chicken and barbecue ribs in the area. Or join us for Sunday brunch at the Old Barn Out Back. We also have an excellent staff to serve you and take care of your needs. So join us on West Elm Street in Lima.
Double your comfort without doubling the price with Lane Action's Buy One, Get One Free Recliner Sale going on now at Westridge Furniture in Delphus. You'll receive double the service from our staff when making your selection of Wall Saver or Rocker recliners in six different styles available in many fabrics and colors. Prices range from $3.99 to $7.99 a pair. To make it double worthwhile, we are offering this three-piece Lane Action set for $13.99. Double your savings. Stop into Westridge Furniture today.
And welcome back to Wapakoneta High School. Tonight, TV 44 brings you Destination Columbus, the Division IV district title game, the Minster Wildcats, and the Marion Local Flyers. This portion of tonight's game is brought to you by Buster and Jeff's Corner Cafe in Mariastein. Eat or carry out. For reservations, call 925-4031. That's Buster and Jeff's Corner Cafe. Tonight's game is also brought to you by the Minster State Bank. Good luck to both teams in tonight's games from the Minster Bank, providing financial solutions for a lifetime. Tonight's game is also brought to you by Bergman Tool and Machine Company. For custom machine and long and short run production, it's Bergman Tool and Machine Company. Bergman Tool and Machine means quality, reliability, and professionalism. Also, tonight sponsoring the game is Gagel Hardware Company. Gagel Do It Best Hardware, with small town family values and service that can't be beat. We offer plumbing, heating, and electrical contracting and full computer service. We're more than just a hardware store, located in downtown Mariastein. Tonight's game is also brought to you by Prudential. For professional investment and insurance services, see Prudential representative Ted Beckman in Minster. That's Prudential. Tonight's sponsor of the game is also Mariastein Animal Clinic, reminding you that spring is heartworm testing time for your dog. Congratulations to the area athletes on their accomplishments. Tonight's game is also brought to you by Mariastein Grain Company. Mariastein Grain Company will supply you with a complete line of feed and animal health products, chemical and fertilizer, and the latest products for lawn and turf care. The friendly people at Mariastein Grain wish our Flyers the best of luck in the tournament trail. And tonight's game is also brought to you by the Village Sports Shop. Your source for Marion Local embroidery and silk screening sports apparel is the Village Sports Shop, State Route 274 in Chickasaw. Also, double your TV pleasure at Toby TV and Maria Stein. Get a second receiver free with the purchase of a Dish Network satellite TV system plus free basic professional installation. Call Toby TV and Maria Stein at 925-4022. Tonight's game is also brought to you by the Knights of St. John's. The Knights of St. John and Maria Stein take pride in supporting the Flyers and would like to remind you to try their chicken fry every fourth Saturday of the month. Tonight's game also brought to you by Juliet's Baton Studio. Juliet's Baton Studio in Minster will be accepting new students in September. Call Julie Jenkins at 628-8300 to enroll. Brookside Holland, with offices located in Lima and Maria Stein, is also sponsoring tonight's game. Contractors spread gravel quickly and evenly with Stone Slider, now available from Brookside Hauling. Tonight's game is also being sponsored by the doctors and the staff of the Schwederman Medical Practice in Maria Stein. Good luck to both teams in tonight's game, also from the Minster Eagles, number 1391. Eagle members, remember to stop in after the game. Also, we are open for lunch during the week with daily specials, and the new building will be opening soon for the Minster Eagles. And tonight's game is also brought to you by the Osgood State Bank. They're proud to sponsor tonight's game. Osgood State Bank, 275 West Main Street in Osgood, Ohio. Member FDIC. We do it all just for you. This is Mike Shep along with Mark Miller. Glad you could join us here on Destination Columbus, the Division IV district title game featuring two foes from the Midwest Athletic Conference, the Minster Wildcats and the Marion Local Flyers. They played during the regular season, and that game was won by Marion Local 53-50. There's the Minster squad. They'll be the home team in the white, and Marion Local will be the road team in the blue. Marion Local is going to go with Kevin Toby, Mitch Kanapke, Brian Walters, Bart Heckman, and Corey Eink. They are coached by Keith Westrick, 19-3 on the year. Minster goes with Jonathan Pining, Dustin Summer, Brad Pringer, David Patch, and Alex Smeezing. They are coached by Mike Lee, and they are 18-4 on the year. To get to this game, Marion Local defeated Fort Recover in Upper Soda Valley, Minster with wins over Spencerville and Perry. Our officials for tonight's game, from left to right, Jonathan Gurney, Chris Gutman, and Rob Lee. Well, when you talk about the special atmosphere tournament, the high school basketball, Mark Miller, it's certainly prevalent in this gymnasium tonight.
Well, there are no open seats, and they were standing and yelling the whole warm-up. It's just an amazing atmosphere, and these kids will never forget this, but a little pressure early on. This kind of a crowd and this kind of a gym, this big a game, there you can see them. They're bouncing on all sides, not just the kids. The older folks are standing, too, so it's an exciting night.
The winner will play Tuesday night down at Miami of Ohio, down in Oxford, against either Bodkins or Fayetteville in a regional semifinal. So that's what's at stake here this evening. And the way the brackets were drawn up, a lot of people thought this would be the matchup in the district finals, these two squads right here. And it's the two big guys, Eink and Schmeezing, in center circle. And it's controlled by Marion Local to start the proceedings. Marion Local, not really a perimeter-based team that much. They have 46 threes in the year. They like to go more inside of their big guys. Eink, who missed a lot of the year with a foot injury, and this youngster right here, Walters, who's very effective scoring inside.
Well, they're in a zone right now for that reason, Mike. Not the great outside shooting.
And the shot that time by Toby wouldn't go, and one shot only that time for the Marion Local Flyers.
Marion Local plays an aggressive defense. They look like they're in a zone too, but they'll come out and attack the guy with the ball.
Well, they only give up 46 points a game. And they're a physical team. A lot of these kids played on that state championship football team. And they're a strong squad. So it looks like points could be hard to come by for both teams tonight.
Well, they haven't gotten it inside of 20 feet from the basket yet. There's a little penetration.
Very patient, Minster is with the basketball right now. Remember, Mark and I will be picking our Stolle Insurance Hustle Award winner at the end of this game tonight. Three's taken off the wing that time by Summer, and it doesn't go. He's the one that hit for seven threes in the semifinal. And Mitch Kanapke brings it down the floor. And the shot put up off the iron that time by Heckman, and is cleared away by Patch. Mike Lee with play instructions to his youngsters as they bring it down the floor with Pining, their primary ball handler. Looks like Mister's going to need to penetrate a little bit and try to get the ball inside some. Summer's got a free look, though. He's 0 for 2 now. And rebound controlled that time by Walters.
Now, the Heckman defense again is opposite here. They're giving the outside shot.
And Heckman hits it.
See, they're both playing zone. One attacks the ball, the other packs it in and makes you make that three. And why not? You talked about only 46 threes and 38 of them coming in by two players.
And that's a 21st three of the year by Heckman. And it's 3-0, Marion Local with the lead.
Now at the other end, Summer is the only guy that's shot the ball. He's laid up two long ones, missed them both.
This is sneezing inside. Went up against Ike. That could be a good matchup tonight. Played 2.5 minutes here at Wapakoneta High School. Marion Local, the only score thus far.
Yeah, with Ike and Schmeezy, you got two tall kids that also have good strength. They're not skinny kids. They both score. They both play physical.
Mitch Canapke with the foul there. This portion of tonight's game brought to you by Community First Bank and Trust. We'd like to wish good luck to all area teams in these tournament games. We're proud to support our students at Community First Bank and Trust. So that's also the first foul of this game as well. Called on Canapke. Patch on the baseline, and they get it back. Oh my goodness, the block there by Canapke as he got up off his feet to block that attempt by Pranger.
He blocked
it. Gets another chance.
Yeah, he blocked it and almost saved it.
And Summers takes the three and he hits it. A little bit of penetration work that time. And each team has a three-pointer. And we're tied up over 3 minutes into this one. Now Walters gets it to Heckman. And Heckman's got the nice stroke going.
Great job by Heckman setting his feet and getting balanced. He knew he had plenty of time before the defense got there because they're sinking in there so far. And a nice shot. Now here's some pressure by Marion Local.
And Walters with the penetration that time. Also remind you, this portion of tonight's game is brought to you by the Silver Spur. Congratulations to the Marion Local Flyers on their winning season from the good folks at the Silver Spur. Stop in the Silver Spur for their fish fry every Friday and NASCAR on Sunday. Go Flyers. And that time Summers avoided the travel. It's 5-3. Marion Local has the lead. And Minster has the basketball. And Summers from way downtown. That one wouldn't go. And the long rebound controlled by the Flyers. They get it down here to Ike. And then Ike loses the handle, but he was fouled. And David Patch is the guilty party.
Well, you're going to see the ball on this replay. You're going to see him kick it out to a big guy. This is 6'7", and they throw the ball down the floor, and he takes it with his left hand, starts to dribble. That's why he's going to play Division I basketball.
Toby's going to take a three. He can't hit it, but Ike on the rebound, up and in. Corey Ike with his first basket, and it's 7-3. Marion Local has a lead. We thank Community First Bank and Trust for our replays this evening. And Toby's called for the blocking foul. That's his first and the second team foul. Take a look.
You see the backside number one rebound position on the missed outside shot. You let Ike get the ball there, you count it.
So Minster needs a basket here. They're down 7-3. And that shot is up and in that time by Pranger.
Boy, he really created a shot there.
Yeah, that looked like it was something from the NBA that put up the one-hander. And then Walters the other way is in and out. Heckman fights hard for the rebound. And a foul is going to be called here against Minster on the rebounding sequence.
There's David a shot that he created. Look at that one-hander just over Ike's outstretched arm. Beautiful shot.
David Patch was called for that foul. That's now two team fouls. That's the first foul, called against Minster.
Austin Kaler, number 40 in the game for Minster.
And that's Heckman again with a three. Boy, Bart Heckman has 8 points tonight, including two threes to make it 10-5. Marion Local has the lead. He must like this gym. He hit a couple threes on the Wednesday night semifinal, also against Upper Soda Valley. So it's 10-5. Flyers with the lead and Minster with the basketball.
Well, Ekman's really prospering from them packing it in on Ike. They're going to have to make a decision now, Minster is.
And off the run, the shot by Pringer doesn't go. And the rebound controlled by Ekman. Excuse me, that was Kanepi with the rebound. Good patience. Now Heckman switches sides, and that one is short. Rebound to Kanapke. He can't hit it. And the ball's loose and controlled by Minster.
Good job by Austin Kaler keeping that thing alive.
So a couple chances that time for Marion Local, but they couldn't connect. Well, they're all over Summers. They're not going to give him any free looks.
Yeah, they've seen enough of his shooting already.
So Pining on the penetration gets the friendly roll.
Well, a couple of penetrations after early on, only getting a shot from the perimeter.
And it's now 10-7.
Wow.
That's Corey Eink with the soft touch after the move.
That was impressive. He went left-handed baseline and laid it up around the backboard with his right hand.
And that makes the score 12-7. 5-point lead now with Marion Local. Under 1:40 left in the quarter. Remember, Eink didn't play in the first game. Summer from well downtown is too hard with that one, and Everman has the one bounce rebound. Heckman, excuse me. Corey Eink is open. His shot is off the window too hard. And the tip rebound out to Summers.
Well, if Eink would have hit that outside shot, he would have really had Minster confused. You don't see a big guy take a shot like that very often. He put it off the glass pretty soft.
1 minute left here in this first quarter. Marion Local with the 5-point lead at 12-7. Smejian hasn't touched the ball hardly at all in any scoring position for Minster. He's their big guy, number 50.
Good job again. That's Pringer. He's done a good job trying to penetrate, make something happen. He drew the foul.
And Heckman is called for the personal. That is now three team fouls against Marion Local. And at the foul line for Minster is Brad Pringer, who's an 86% foul shooter. In fact, Minster as a team shoots 73% from the foul line, so they do pretty well from the strike.
Yeah, that's really good.
And off of this, a shot doesn't go that time, but Sneezing has the rebound. And another foul is called here.
Well, Corey Eink just left the ball game. Matt Reckner, 6'6 junior, number 35, replaced him, and right away, Sneezing gets the ball. Off the rebound.
And I'll say it was a non-shooting foul. So Minster will inbound underneath their basket.
Also in John Rose, a 6'3 senior. So some of the Marion Local starters getting a rest here for the last minute of the quarter.
Now we're under 30 seconds left.
Number 22, Andy Redgerman. I hope I'm saying that right, Andy.
Summers again, he can't hit it. Redgerman gets the rebound, he's hammered. Redgerman, we think is how it's pronounced.
6'2 junior.
Take a look at our Community First Bank and Trust replay. And Mark Miller mentioned when Eink out of the game, the Minster team is really hitting the offensive glass.
Yeah, a couple second looks in a row there. And drew a couple of fouls.
And Redgerman, a 69% foul shooter, has his first point. That's now five team fouls against Marion Local. Next on both chances. Now 12-10. Marion Local by two. They'll probably play for the last shot here with under 15 seconds left in this first quarter. Toby puts it up off the move and he hit it. Nice move that time by Toby. And our first quarter comes to a close after one stop. From Wapakoneta, our scores: Marion Local 14, Minster 10.
If you're looking for a good deal on a vehicle without any games or gimmicks, then head to Magnum Truck and Auto. At Magnum, they look at the long-term picture. They want repeat business. Magnum can help you understand GVW, towing capacity, how a lease works, or any other question you may have. Their goal at Magnum is to make each customer a friend. Give that customer the best value for their dollar. Magnum Truck and Auto, locally owned and operated since 1977, located next to I-75 on Blue Lick Road. Your truck specialist is Magnum Truck and Auto, on the web at magnumtruck.com.
Hi, I'm Jennifer Stuckey from 44 Magazine. Not every student can be the point guard or the quarterback, but there are many who have talent and some who are just quietly making the world a better place. We believe that these students deserve their turn in the spotlight, too. Meet one such student.
I play the violin. People don't know the words. How can I minister to them with just an instrument? And a lady came up to me afterwards and said, it speaks words, doesn't it? Even though I may not be singing and saying what the words are, God's using the music.
Besides the academic edge that many homeschool students enjoy, homeschooling has given Marie Morris time and flexibility to excel in music as well.
Our family does a lot of playing together since my brothers and sisters all play an instrument and mom plays. We've played for nursing homes, for assisted livings, for community groups, for all sorts of church groups.
Marie began studying violin at age 4, and now she has several students of her own. In addition to the numerous performances with her family, she also plays in the Lima Area Youth Orchestra, where she hopes to be concertmaster.
Started when I was in 8th grade, and I was a little unsure at first just because it was something all new, but as it ended up, I loved it and had such a good time playing with other people my age who were just having a good time. And I looked forward to every Saturday morning. And so I've been in it 4 years now, and I'm excited about auditions coming up again. I am grateful for the opportunities because then I can share a lot of songs that have spiritual meaning, a lot of hymns, and, you know, give somebody some depth to listen to, give them God's message there in the music.
To see who else will be in the spotlight, watch 44 Magazine each Tuesday here on TV 44 at 12:30, 5:30, and 9.
And welcome back to Wapakoneta High School. We're at halftime to this Division IV district title game. Destination Columbus and Marion Local leads Minster 29-18. I'm Mike Shep along with Mark Miller. We're glad you tuned in to our Friday night, Saturday afternoon replay of high school basketball here at Destination Columbus on TV 44. And let's take a look at our first half statistics. And there you see Minster just miserable shooting, 2 for 12 from inside the arc and 3 for 11 from outside, and 5 for 23 is just not going to cut it at all. Meanwhile, Marion Local 50% from both areas, 1 for 4 from the foul lines, their only concern. Hardly any turnovers in this game, and in a first half that took less than half an hour to play, and Marion Local the slight rebounding edge. Leading scorers in the game, Corey Eink has 9 points in the contest, and Dustin Summer has 9 points to lead the way for Minster. It's an interesting, Marion Local has this 11-point lead, and B.J. Walters, their leading scorer of the year, has not scored a point. I think he's only taken maybe one or two shots. So in a way, that's good news for them, Mark, as they have assumed control in this ballgame.
Yeah, and he's going to assert himself sooner or later. He is a great athlete, and the difference so far is shooting. And a lot of that is defense. Now, we're going to see some looks here. Here's a good shot. This is a sophomore, Summer. The head fake, step around, and hits the three. That's just a beautiful play, but that's one of the very few open looks Minster had. Usually, that matchup man or zone defense has been in their face.
And I think we also have some more footage. There you saw in the background, just the vast crowd here at Wapakoneta High School that has been lined up here. This is some inside work by Marion Local.
That was Walters. He took the shot, but Schmiesing, really bothered him. The tip around goes to Kanapke, and he's right there for the easy putback. So offensive boards, good job by Marion Local on that one. And we didn't have very many turnovers, but here's one. This is Pranger from Minster. He loses his feet right there. And Toby, the guy that we highlighted in the open, gets it, gets knocked up into the stands, and of course the fans got to help the referees make the right call. So that's kind of Mac basketball / football right there.
This is, and there's some football players going at it right there as well. So once again, the 11-point margin here at halftime for Marion Local. This portion of tonight's game brought to you by Buster and Jeff's Corner Cafe. It's good food and fun at Buster and Jeff's Corner Cafe in Maria Stein. Eat in or carry out. For reservations, call 925-4031. Tonight's game also brought to you by the Minster State Bank. Good luck to both teams in tonight's game from all of us at the Minster State Bank, providing financial solutions for a lifetime. Our next basketball action here on TV 44 Destination Columbus will be the Division II district title game. The co-champs of the Western Buckeye League going at it. Van Wert and Ottawa Glandorf, a special time, 6 o'clock Saturday evening on TV 44. And then Saturday at 10:30, it will be Lima Senior going up against Toledo Scott for the Division I district title. So two more district championship games coming your way here on TV 44 this weekend. Once again, our halftime score is Marion Local 29 and Minster 18.
The Union Bank Company, we're committed to serving you.
I've been very satisfied with the Union Bank. They were very helpful in tailoring a financial package which fit my specific needs for my building project.
I would recommend Union Bank to any professional starting out in business. Their professionalism is unsurpassed. Union Bank has been very helpful as far as getting things done in a timely fashion, being very prompt, very professional, very courteous.
I feel that working with a local bank was extremely important. With the decisions being made locally, I feel that they could tailor a package to fit my specific needs.
If you want to experience a higher level of satisfaction with your professional or business banking services, give us a call or stop by one of our 6 offices.
Committed to serving the community, committed to you, Union Bank.
And welcome back to Walpock Nutter, where tonight's game is brought to you by Community First Bank and Trust, where our fixed rate mortgages are the lowest they've been in several years. Now's the perfect time to refinance your existing loan or purchase your dream home. It's simple, easy, and convenient. Just stop in and see one of our friendly loan officers at any of our Community First Bank and Trust locations, member FDIC. And tonight's game is also brought to you by St. John's Catering. For catering from 10 to 10,000 people, see Pat and Lisa at St. John's Catering. Try the Lenten specials, a 3-piece dinner, 3-piece for dinner or $3, or 21-piece shrimp dinner for $3.50. This is Mike Shep along with Mark Miller. Glad you could join us. Second half of action down underway here. Destination Columbus, the Division IV district championship game, and Marion Local in the blue has the lead, their biggest of the night at 29-18. And Walters is tied up that time. Nice defensive play by David Patch. And the ball goes over to Minster.
Here you're going to see it. They get the pass into Walters, but right away, they knock it away and tie him up. Good job by Patch. Pressure defense. You know, right out of the shoot, second half, Minster Marion Minster opened up in a man-to-man. They're not going to play that zone anymore. Marion Local still with their zone. And why not? 18 points and a half.
And Minster was 5-for-23 in the first half as well. So right now, Minster doesn't have an answer for the zone as of yet.
You know, the difference is shooting, but why? Uncontested looks for Marion Local and people with hands in their faces for Minster. Tough time even getting it close enough for a shot right now.
Operating right in front of the Minster bench, Mike Lee with instructions to his kids, maybe trying to get something on the inside. They do get it to Sneezing. He's surrounded by the enemy, and then a foul's called here. And it's going to be called against Sneezing.
Well, they finally get into Sneezing, and there you can see 3 Marion Local guys on him. Now, he thought it was a tied-up ball, and he came away with it, but he got called for the foul.
First team foul of the half, so both teams have come up empty on their first possessions here in the third quarter. Marion Local maintains the 11-point lead. The winner plays Tuesday night against either Bodkins or Fayetteville in the regional down at Oxford on the campus of Miami of Ohio. Corey Eich, the nice move down low, count with the foul. Well, Corey Eich with 11 points, the youngster who's been had a frustrating season with a foot injury, but we see some visibility right here.
Well, this is his season. You know, the regular season pretty much was a throwaway trying to get ready to be full strength, and so the tournament season is his season.
So Corey Eich looking for the 3-point play right here, and Schmiesing was called for the foul. And Eich shows a nice touch there And it's now a 13-point lead for Marion Local at 31-18. This is their biggest margin early here. 32-18 with the foul shot, excuse me. Here early in this third quarter. Shot put up off the iron twice that time by Brad Pringer. But then Marion Local's called for the foul. B.J. Walters trying to do a little politicking for his side, but I think he's the guilty party here.
Yeah, the referee would have none of it. He said, son, you pushed off.
And there
right
you see
there
it.
You see the hand.
With the left hand.
That was a great shot by the camera to show you that foul.
Boy, as Mark mentioned, though, Minster having a tough time just making the routine passes. That inbounds pass was an adventure.
Well, Marion Local, as you said, is tall, and aside from that, they're athletic and they're strong. They can play defense.
And Corey Hines called for a pushing foul before Sneezing got a chance to take the shot. We had very few fouls in the first half. Neither team got into the bonus. A first half that took less than half an hour to play. Take a look at our Community First Bank and Trust replay.
Minster would love to get Summer freed up. He was their outside shooter, but you can see he gets lots of attention when he gets it.
And inside, Sneezing too hard with it. Tough break there, out of bounds, controlled by Minster. And this portion of tonight's game brought to you by Carriage Works. Carriage Works wishes good luck to both teams in tonight's game. At Carriage Works, we specialize in collision repair for foreign and domestic vehicles. Carriage Works, located north of St. Henry on State Route 118. And the shot put up, and we have another foul called here on the rebounding sequence.
Well, it's been at this end for a long time, and it's been a rough trip for B.J. Walter, I'll tell you that.
Well, the shot was put up by Brad Pringer that time. And Walters has called for his second foul. So he's picked up two quick ones here in the second half. Three team fouls now for Marion Local, and Minster's committed two. One-hander put up there by Pringer wouldn't go, but Minster gets it back. Well, this has been a long trip, as Mark mentioned.
That was Patch that got that and knocked it back out to a teammate.
Sneezing has it against Ike, and they get it to Summers. And Summers is short with it, and Corey Ike has the rebound. So after all that, no scoring by Minster.
And that's got to be frustrating for the Minster players. They worked their tail off, got numerous opportunities, and came away with not the same score as they had before.
Ike well on the outside right now. And a foul is called here against Minster. It's going to be called on David Patch. Well, this portion of tonight's game also brought to you by the St. Henry State Bank. Good luck, Flyers, from all of us at the St. Henry Bank. For current interest rates and information on all of our services, check out our webpage at www.sthenrybank.com.
How about that? St. Henry Bank wishing Marion Local good luck. I imagine they do have a branch in Maria Stein. That's a competitive series there, too.
Ike, a little turnaround, in and out, tough break there, has a nice touch on it, and only one shot. But Minster, they've scored only 8 points since the start of the second quarter, so that's almost 12 minutes of basketball that we've played. And they've managed only 8 points since then. Now Sneezing has it, and he gets it up over the rim.
Well, they got it into Sneezing with Ike far enough away that Sneezing could go in on a smaller guy.
32-20, Ekman's open for the triple, but that is too hard. Pining has the rebound. So we approach the midway point of this third quarter. Minster down by 12 with the basketball. Shot put up here by Reckerman. It won't go, but another chance coming up here for the Wildcats. Brad Pringer got the ball. A lot of offensive rebounds here in the second half for Minster.
Yeah, they've tied the rebounding totals up. We don't keep offensive and defensive, but a lot here in the third quarter. They're pounding the boards. Now, they've got to have something to show for it sooner or later, or the effort goes away. Pringer, one of the few guys from Minster, able to penetrate and get the ball inside.
And Sneezing wants to take it to the basket over Ike. He couldn't get it to go, and Walters with a nice position. So the score remains 32-20 with 3:20 left here in the quarter, and a great look that time from Ike to Heckman. Bart Heckman puts it in. He now has 10 points. Now remember, Mark and I will be picking our Stolle Insurance Hustle Award winner at the end of this game tonight. We have a full timeout called on the floor. Our score is Marion Local 34, Minster 20.
What does Toyota offer you for less than $9,000? What does Honda offer you for less than $9,000? What does Hyundai offer you for less than $9,000?
The 2001 Hyundai Accent for only $87.99 with a 10-year, 100,000-mile warranty. Come let us knock your socks off.
At the Stolle Insurance Group, we're a family of insurance professionals that's been serving West Central Ohio since 1904. We pride ourselves on finding just the right insurance or investment program to meet the needs of all our customers. We're a full-service independent agency representing many insurance carriers, including the CNA insurance companies. So contact the Stolle Insurance Group and meet our family of insurance professionals looking out for you, your business, and your family.
Are you tired of slow, unresponsive internet? Tired of getting busy signals? Tired of missing phone calls? For internet that is always on and requires no telephone connection? For internet as fast as you would change a page in Excel or Word? For super high-speed internet at an extremely reasonable price starting at $39? For internet that is for businesses and homes in the 45801 to the 45807 zip code? For the fastest, most reliable internet in the Lima area? Call Cobra Wireless Internet from Watch TV and Lima Telephone. Call 99-WATCH or 221-0066.
And welcome back to Wapakoneta High School, where this portion of tonight's game is brought to you by Buster and Jeff's Corner Cafe. Eat in or carry out at Buster and Jeff's Corner Cafe in Maria Stein. For reservations, call 925-4031. Tonight's game is also brought to you by the Minster State Bank. Good luck to both teams at tonight's game from all of us at the Minster State Bank, providing financial solutions for a lifetime at the Minster State Bank. Well, that was the first time out of this game taken as we approach the three-minute mark of the third quarter, but right now, Minster's on the critical list. They are down by 14 points, and they need to get back in this game and get some scoring. And there was an air ball that time by Summers.
Well, he's trying to get the shot off. Had a very small window to shoot it in. Look at the big guy driving.
Oh, my goodness. Corey Eink, I don't know if you want to set up for a charge against that power plant. He makes the 36-20, and Marion Local's on the verge of making this a blowout here with under 3 minutes to go in the third.
Yeah, Minster's got to solve this defense and get some points to get back in this thing.
Smeezy it inside over Heitkamp, count out with the foul.
Well, that's one way to do it, get it into the big guy.
So Alex Smeezy with his second basket of the quarter, he has 6 points. And the foul is going to be called against Matt Reckner, excuse me, not Heitkamp. Four team fouls now against Marion Local, three for Minster. Walter's got a brief rest at Kanapke. They'll come back on the floor. It's little nuances like that sometimes, Mark, that the general public doesn't notice. Getting your players, your frontline players, just maybe 35, 40 seconds, maybe a minute of rest during the heat of battle.
That's right. It doesn't take much, but in an up and down game like this is, with very few stoppages, you need a minute on the bench to catch your breath.
And Alex Smeezing shows a nice stroke with the three-point play. Makes it 36-23. Marion Local by 13 in the latter stages of our third quarter. This is Reckner. He puts a shot up, in and out, not there. The ball is tipped around and controlled by Smeezing. So that time only one shot for the Flyers. Summers takes the three. It's off the side of the board. Smeezy gets the rebound. He can't hit it. And the ball is blocked out of bounds that time, as Pringer thought he had a legitimate shot. Mike Lee thought he got fouled. But Kanapke with the block that time.
Well, Kanapke's shown he can really get off the floor. There's a shot. Not a bad look by Summers, but you see Wolders coming at him. The miss off the edge of the backboard. Smeezy tries to get it up. And then the backside rebound and the block.
Corey Eink comes back into the game. We're now under the two-minute mark here in the third quarter. Boy, that time, Pringer just had to manufacture something. He was going to force the issue, and he did, and he got fouled.
Well, Lank's back in, and you said about a minute rest, especially for the big guys. The little guys, they can kind of catch their breath at the foul line sometimes, but the big guys, you know, they got to run further than anybody else because they're going from basket to basket.
And they're carrying more of a load,
that's
too.
Right.
And around and in is Brad Pringer, who's an 86% foul shooter. And a nice stroke there by Pringer. Now with 6 points in the game, and it's 36-25. Last 5 points been scored by Minster. They've cut the lead to 11 as we approach a minute and a half to go here in the third quarter.
Well, Schmeezing's out, and that means Austin Kaler is guarding Corey Ike.
Ike's well on the outside right now where he has the ball, almost like a safety valve. Rector looking inside, and that pass was too tall for everybody, and the turnover goes against Marion Local. But as Mark mentioned, very few turnovers in this game.
Yeah, we got a total of 7.
And as far as the floor game goes, it's been pretty well played. Just a better shooting tonight by Marion Locals, giving us the 11-point margin. But that time they turned it over, so Minster has a chance to get the deficit in single digits here. With 1:10 remaining in the third quarter.
Well, credit Minster. They didn't let it get away from them. They kept working. A shot here. They're looking pretty good from what they came out in the second half. Just finding an open shot is a tough part against this defense.
So Pringer puts the shot up off the window. It's not there. Ball tipped around. A nice job that time by Canapi, getting it down to Toby. His shot is too hard. And then we have a foul on the rebound, I believe, against Marion Local.
Looks like they got B.J. Walters on the rebound. We're going to get a look at it.
Community First Bank and Trust replay here.
You see the ball come off. Kanapke tips it to himself, and then what you didn't see is he tipped it ahead to Toby. And right there is the foul.
Good job on the replay. That's Jason on camera 4. Good job there. Under 35 seconds left now in this third quarter. Score remains 36-25. Minster's had some chances to cut into this lead, but they turn it over. Toby holds things up, and I think they're going to try to play for the final shot. Corey Ike well outside with the ball. Now Ike back where he's a little bit more comfortable. This is Toby with it. Under 10 seconds down. Minster needs to pull the trigger and do so quickly. Corey Ike will do so, and he hits it. And that's a 3, and that ends the third quarter. Three-pointer by Corey Ike, and after 3 stops, it is Marion Local 39, Minster 25.
Since 1980, we have been servicing the Limeland area vehicles. I feel proud knowing that I have treated my customers honestly and fairly. At Elida Road Tire Service, we are proud to sell and service Bridgestone, Firestone, and Dayton tires. The Firestone FT70C delivers an outstanding wet stopping and wet traction to give you an edge in the rain. The FT70C also delivers long wear, good snow traction, and a smooth, quiet ride. Remember, at Elida Road Tire Service, we are a full service facility.
Arby's asks, what would you call a sandwich that blends the delicious flavors of a savory mushroom sauce with creamy mild Swiss?
The Swiss Shroomarama.
All atop tender and succulent slow-roasted beef?
The Grand Shroomer.
Surely there's a name that can do justice to a sandwich with this kind of flavor.
The Mega Mush Swiss?
On second thought, maybe simple is best. Arby's new Mushroom and Swiss. Simple name, exciting flavor. So don't settle for ordinary. Get to Arby's and satisfy your grown-up tastes.
Double your comfort without doubling the price with Lane Action's buy one, get one free recliner sale going on now at Westridge Furniture in Delphus. You'll receive double the service from our staff when making your selection of wall saver or rocker recliners in six different styles available in many fabrics and colors. Prices range from $399 to $799 a pair. To make it double worthwhile, we are offering this three-piece Lane Action set for $1399. Double your savings. Stop into Westridge Furniture today.
And welcome back to Wapak Netta. This portion of tonight's game brought to you by Community First Bank and Trust. We'd like to wish good luck to all our area teams in these tournament games. That's Community First Bank and Trust. We're proud to support our area athletes. That was Corey Eich with the deuce, so he finished the third quarter with a triple, and then a basket there makes it 41-25. And Marion Local has their biggest lead of the night at 16 points, just underway in our fourth quarter.
5 points in the last 5 seconds. That's tough for Minster. They were just whittling it down a little bit to get it in single digits. Now a 16-point lead.
Remember, the regular season game went to Marion Local 53-50. That's when Corey Eich didn't play. And he's making his presence felt here tonight with 19 points to lead all scores.
Well, that certainly is something that the teams in Marion Local's division has to be aware of, is that they were ranked number one and they didn't have their Division I recruited player playing most of the season. Now, I realize there's a lot of chemistry that had to be redesigned, but he's looking pretty good right now, and the team is playing well with him.
Yeah, Marion Local's played excellent ball here in the tournament after two regular season losses to close out the year to Rushi and Delphus St. John's. Heckman, the turnaround goes. Bart Heckman, one of our leading candidates for the Stolle Insurance Hustle Award. And we're on the verge of a full-fledged blowout here at 43-25. Second minute of action here in the final quarter. When Mark's talked about this matchup zone, Minster hasn't had an answer for it the whole night. They got it to Smeezy where they wanted to have it there. That was a great feed that time by David Patch, and Smeezy now with nine.
The first time I thought tonight they had a definitive plan and made it work against that matchup zone.
And inside, Corey Eich. Nice look that time from Walters.
Yeah, Walters in football caught a lot of passes. That time he threw a real nice one inside.
45-27. Marion Local back up by 18 as we approach 6 minutes to go.
Those kinds of plays are frustrating for a team trying to make a comeback. You make a big shot, the other team comes right back and hits another one.
Well, just throwing up a prayer that time was Brad Pranger, and it wasn't answered. Take a look at the shot selection by the two teams, and it's one of the reasons why Marion Local has this definitive lead. Inside, Eich again.
Well, Schmeezing's tired again, and Eich is having his way.
And Minster wants to take a timeout, and they do so. Timeout on the floor. Our score is Marion Local 47, Minster 27.
Pilot to go, pilot. A bogey, two flark.
Hey, what you do on your deck to relax is your business. It's what you don't want to do that's our business. Trex Easy Care Decking.
Trex, available now at Lima Lumber.
What does Toyota offer you for less than $9,000? What does Honda offer you for less than $9,000? What does Hyundai offer you for less than $9,000?
The 2001 Hyundai Accent for only $87.99 with a 10-year, 100,000-mile warranty. Come let us knock your socks off.
Hi, I'm Bill. I'd like to invite you to M&M&M, 2 miles south of Cridersville. We carry an extensive inventory of truck accessories. We also have hop cap, truck caps. We have the Toughliner bed liner that forms to fit the dimensions of the truck. We at M&M&M Sales will try to answer all your truck accessory questions. But best of all, for all your other questions.
See M&M&M Sales and Service at 19129 County Road 25A, just south of Cridersville.
And welcome back to tonight's action, which is being brought to you by the Carriage Works. Carriage Works wishes good luck to both teams in tonight's game. At Carriage Works, we specialize in collision repair for both foreign and domestic vehicles. Carriage Works, located north of St. Henry on State Route 118. Also, good luck flyers from the St. Henry Bank. For current interest rates and information on all our services, check out our webpage at www.sthenrybank.com. We'd like to thank all of our sponsors who help make high school basketball possible here on TV 44. Well, the miss that time by David Patch goes out of bounds, controlled by Marion Local. We're going to take a look at our third quarter stats. There you see that right now, Minster is shooting 7 for 36. That is under 20% from the field. They are shooting well from the foul line. The rebounding's even. Turnover's not a factor, but there you see that Minster still, Marion Local still at that 50% shooting range. Nice move here by Walters, counted with the foul. That's been his meal ticket all year.
He's quick off the dribble, and he gets up around the rim when he lays him in. And the only way you're going to stop him is to foul him.
That's his first basket of the night. He's our leading scorer at 18 points per game. Shows the great quickness, the All-State wide receiver looking for the three-point play. And that makes the score 50-27. Minster in control of this one. Marion Local in control of this one, excuse me, with 5 minutes left.
Corey Yank has 23, Minster has 27. What a great defensive effort by the Flyers.
Shot put up that time, doesn't go by Patch, only one shot for the Minster Wildcats. Coming into this game with an 18-4 record. Not too often you see a team with only four losses get dominated the way it's happening here tonight. Kanapke, outside to Ike, and Corey Ike puts it in.
And finger roll.
Corey Ike putting on a show tonight with 25 points, nearly half of his squad's points, and it's 52-27. And then Heckman comes away with the steal, and he lays it in. Right now, Marion Local has doubled things up at 54-27. Just the final score needs to be decided in this one. It's Marion Local is well on their way to a district championship game and a berth in the regional semis next Tuesday night at Oxford.
So well, I think a big part of the halftime talk for Marion Local was we've got to get a face or a hand in the face of Summers. Dustin Summer, the guy that we talked about in the pregame, he hit a couple of big shots there in the first half, kind of kept Minster hanging around. Lately, he hasn't even seen the ball.
And Ike blocks that shot away, and Toby goes the other way with it, and he's hammered. So Kevin Toby will go to the free throw line.
All right. We're going to show you about this defense here. There's the tip away. That's Heckman, the kid that's had a great game. Looks like he's got some ups too. There's just a lot of athletes on Marion Local's team, I'll tell you that. I don't know how many of them play football, but they're put together. If they didn't play football, they lifted with the football team.
And Kevin Toby now has 9 points in the game. And he'll be getting one more. And off the miss, it goes out of bounds to the Flyers. So that's the type of night it's been for Marion Local and for Minster, respectively.
It goes bad, doesn't it?
Walters wants to put it up. Can't get it to go. Ball being tipped around and bounced around, and Smeezing finally has control. Boy, some of these Minster players look tired, Smeezing especially. It's frustrating working against this defense and not getting any looks. Out of bounds off of Minster.
I think that was a fatigue turnover. Not ready for the ball. Well, a game effort by the Wildcats. They just ran up against a team that's really hitting their stride and a team that played great defense tonight.
And Tony Kemper reports into the game for Minster. This is Walters in the baseline. He loves to operate around here. Then he gets it outside to Ike. Ike with it against Smeezy, and then they throw it away.
Well, Ike trying to be unselfish. He's done a good job of that. A good passer. He tried to kick it all the way across baseline.
Tomorrow at 6 o'clock, remember, we'll have the Division II district title game. Van Wert and Ottawa Glandorf, the co-champs of the Western Buckeye League, go at it. That's a 6 o'clock replay tomorrow night on TV 44. Then Lima Senior and Toledo Scott at 10:30 tomorrow night for the Division I district title. So we've had three district championship games this weekend here for you on WTLW TV 44 Sports. Now we're down to 2:40 remaining. Minster with the ball, but Marion Local just that far away from getting their hands on a district championship trophy. Marion Local's going to make some full-scale substitutions. The next dead ball, inside it goes, and a foul's called as Kaler was able to get the ball in a good spot. And he's going to go to the free throw line with 2:22 remaining. First at Bank and Trust replay, and this is something Minster needed to do a little bit more of earlier in the game.
You have Smeezing and then the bounce pass to the baseline.
Corey Ike's going to come out of the game. Big game for him with 25 points. I know this means a lot to all these kids, Mark, but probably especially to Corey Ike. When he hurt his foot, he had to wonder.
Yeah.
If he was going to play anymore this
year. That's right. And even with all their success, you really don't feel you're a part unless you're out there doing something, and he wasn't able to do it.
And there's Bart Heckman. He is our Stolle Insurance Hustle Award winner. We salute Bart. He'll be invited to our banquet at the end of basketball season and receive a plaque courtesy of Stolle Insurance for his play in tonight's game. I think his outside shooting started the game and opened things up on the inside. 55-29 our score now. Marion Local the ball and the lead with 2 minutes left.
Well, what a thrill for some of these guys to play in a district championship game. A lot of times you don't have the luxury of getting in too many off your bench.
And just for everyone's information, Marion Local's JV team was undefeated this year. So their run will continue.
Well, I talked to some folks that talked about Marion Local state championship football team, and they said, don't get too excited. They're going to come back again and be as good next year. So there must be a run of athletes in the school down there.
And a lot of the Minster kids are going to be coming out as well. As Mark mentioned, they put up a game effort tonight, but it would have taken a heck of a team and a heck of an effort to put a victory up against Marion Local this evening the way they've played. Craig Walters is now in the game for Marion Local. Some other players from the bench, Matt Reckner as well. We're under 2 minutes to go. 55-29. It's been a dominant performance for Marion Local here tonight.
And boy, what patience the second team is showing. Tell you what, when I was a second teamer, that baby went to the rim.
And the patience ends up with a turnover.
See, they should shoot it.
Yeah.
Get your name in the box score.
And Minster probably should have shot it as well there. Says Ty Hankeline let that ball get out of bounds. So the turnover there against Minster.
Heckman and Kanapke. Boy, they had nice games tonight. Number 20, Aaron Schulze, 5'10", junior into the ball game. Marion Local.
So Marion Local will head down to Oxford on Tuesday night, taking on either Botkins or Fayetteville. I think that they play tomorrow night down at the University of Dayton for a district title. Now under a minute left. Just the final score needs to be determined here at Wapakoneta. Special thanks to Tom Hunter, the Redskins athletic director, and his staff for hosting TV 44 Sports. Marion Local have fond memories of this gymnasium as they put together a very strong district tournament. And a push foul is going to be called here against Brent Eversman. And it'll be bonus time for Minster with 38 seconds left. We have two schools here with very loyal followings, though, as hardly any of the Minster folks have left.
Yeah, no, they haven't left. They're still cheering. Students are still standing. They cheer all the starters as they came out. Very appreciative, very loyal fans. You love to see that. You don't like to see the ones that as soon as you're down by 10, they head for the car.
Tony,
that car is still going to be there.
Free throw line. He made one, and then he hit it. Nothing on the next one, so that makes it 55-30. And Marion Local will have the ball here to the last 30 seconds winds down.
People from bigger schools wonder how all these little schools can have such athletic dynasties. And that's part of it, the following, the support they get.
And the shots put up that time by Craig Walters was partially blocked. Now under 15 seconds to go. And Minster with the basketball. Well, the Marion Local Flyers made this one look easy tonight from start to finish. They took a 4-point lead at the end of the first quarter and never looked back. Our final score here this evening in this district championship game. The Marion Local Flyers 55 and the Minster Wildcats 30.
Does your business or organization need that something extra to make you stand out? Then check out Imageries, your total image maker. Imageries can put your logo on just about anything. How about embroidered hats or shirts, knit denim, and much more? We also handle promotional items. Put your name on pens, frisbees, coffee mugs, letter openers, almost anything. Imageries can handle all sizes of orders from one to thousands with a service and expertise to make sure you're always completely satisfied. Give them a call today or stop in across from the post office on High Street. Imageries, a division of Quick as a Wink. Agape Enterprises is your area's factory-authorized Sunrise window dealer. Sunrise windows are the most energy-efficient, technologically advanced windows on the market. Agape offers the incomparable Energy Savings Ultra U-Plus insulating glass system. Agape offers benchmark award-winning vinyl siding by Wolverine with a fiberglass reinforced stabilizer bar. Spray Creek concrete resurfacing is beautiful, durable, and enhances your property's value. It is stain, salt, crack, oil, and freeze resistant. Remember, Agape means love. You will love our work.
Welcome back to Wapaw, Connecticut tonight. Marion Local leaves no doubt winning the district championship by 25 points. And Keith Westrick joins us. First of all, congratulations on a big win.
Thank you very much. That was a big win. This is a close rivalry every year. It's very intense. I told Mike before the game, I said, how many times have we been in this situation? You know, and it was a 3-point ball game earlier in the season. Last year they knocked us out first round of the sectional final. And these boys remembered that early exit last year, and even though we got them in the regular season, it was in the back of their mind that they were going to go out there and give it 100% all the way through.
Coach, after the two regular season losses at the end of the year, did you address things any differently come tournament? Because these three tournament games your team played have all been very impressive wins.
I think there was a couple of things there. One, we talked last time, if you remember, after the St. Henry game about a possible lull in intensity, and it really did hit. It was just starting at the St. Henry game, and I think the football basketball thing really started to get them burn out a little bit. And plus, that's the time of the year where the school year starts to lag a little bit, too. And I just told him, I said, you can't let the long days of February creep into this basketball season. So by losing to Rushi, by losing to Delphi St. John's, I think it was might have been the best thing could have happened to this team. It didn't hurt the outcome of the league schedule or the league record championship, I should say. It just got them a lot more focused, a lot more dedicated towards what we wanted to accomplish. And it kind of told them that Corey's coming back. We got to regroup and we got to blend together.
Well, Coach, you just certainly did that tonight. Congratulations on a great win. Good luck next week.
I want to just say that Minster is a very fine, very well-coached team. And the fact that we came out and played that type of defense is just a credit to the quality of kids that we have on this team.
No doubt about that, Coach. Congratulations. Good luck Tuesday night.
Thank you.
Mark Miller joins me. We'll take a look at our final numbers here for Marion Local's win over Minster. From two-point range, Marion Local was 18 for 32, and Minster was 5 of 26. From outside the arc, the Flyers were 5 of 10, Minster 3 of 16. From the foul line, the Flyers were 4 out of 8, the Wildcats 11 of 13. Rebounded about even to Marion Local, 24 to 23. Only 5 turnovers for Marion Local, and Minster had 8. Leading scorers in the game, Bart Smezing and Dustin Summers had 9 points apiece to lead the way for Minster, I should say Alex Smezing, while Corey Eink had 25 points to lead all scorers. Minster is done for the year at 18-5, while Marion Local is 20-3. They'll play Tuesday night down at Miami of Ohio in the regional tournament. So, Mark, really no doubt about this one, really, from the start. That matchup zone that the coach alluded to here, there in his closing comment was really the storyline of this game.
Yeah, it really was. Summers hit some big threes early to try to keep them within striking distance, and when they got a better look on him, which I think they talked about at halftime, it was basically over. They just could not penetrate. They couldn't hit the outside shot, a hand in everybody's face, and Ike, you know, looks like he's getting ready for the stretch run, and you know, I'm a Bowling Green graduate, and he's headed up to BG, and I'm pretty happy about that because he's a good player. But there's a lot of good players on that Marion Local team.
Okay, Mark, thanks. It's always a pleasure. Before we go, a special thanks to Tom Hunter for hosting TV 44 Sports. We'll be back with you with the Division II district title game, Van Wert OG, a special replay of 6 o'clock tomorrow night here, or tonight for those of you watching our Saturday replay, 6 o'clock, and then at 10:30 will be Lima Senior and Toledo Scott. Two more district title games coming your way here on TV 44. Our final score here again tonight, Marion Local 55, Minster 30. For Mark and our crew, Mike Shep from Wapakoneta High School, good evening, everybody.
Almighty maker of heaven and maker of earth, and in Jesus Christ is only begotten Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, he was crucified and dead and buried.
Quality vehicles at a fair price can be hard to find. Magnum Truck and Auto goes to great lengths to offer quality vehicles and to make sure each customer they serve is satisfied. At Magnum, you'll find extremely clean late model trucks and SUVs, even commercial trucks and vans. You won't find any games or gimmicks at Magnum Truck and Auto. Magnum believes in teamwork and service after the sale. At Magnum, you can buy, lease, trade, or even sell a vehicle, making them your one-stop source. Magnum Truck and Auto, locally owned and operated since 1977, located east of I-75 on Blue Lick Road. At S&K Mower Service and Repair, we're ready for winter. We have new Simplicity and Snapper snow throwers in stock. They're ready for delivery at the area's best prices. We also service all brands of outdoor power equipment. Pleasing you pleases us. Come see Steve, Mike, and Brad at S&K Mowers Monday through Friday from 8 to 5 and Saturday from 8 to noon. That's S&K Mower Service and Repair, located at 9280 North Dixie Highway in Bluffton.
Are you tired of slow, unresponsive internet? Tired of getting busy signals? Tired of missing phone calls? For internet that is always on and requires no telephone connection? For internet as fast as you would change a page in Excel or Word? For super high-speed internet at an extremely reasonable price starting at $39? For internet that is for businesses and homes in the 45801 to the 45807 zip code? For the fastest, most reliable internet in the Lima area? Call Cobra Wireless Internet from Watch TV and Lima Telephone. Call 99WATCH or 221-0066.
Welcome back. The job cuts keep coming. This week, Bears...
Second play was a bust from the time it was started. Scott was the man who tipped that ball in the last...